Hello and welcome. My name is Abhishek Hemrajani. In this video, I'm going to show you how to get started with Azure Migrate. Azure Migrate is now a hub for all your migration needs and tools. Before we see it in action, let's learn about Azure Migrate and its new features. Azure Migrate provides you a guided experience for the most common migration scenarios. In this video specifically, I'll show you how to get started with migrating servers, databases, and more. You get feature-based grouping of popular Microsoft and ISV tools, which means you have the choice of tools for every phase of a migration process. And finally, with an integrated new experience and end-to-end tracking, you get a consistent view of your data center assets as you migrate them over to Azure. Let's get started. So here I am on the Azure portal. Once you browse to the Azure Migrate experience, you'll find that the overview provides you a few key migration scenarios to help you get started. You'll find curated scenarios for migrating servers, migrating databases, migrating web apps to Azure, or migrating your on-premises data in large volumes to Azure using Azure Data Box. In this video, let's go ahead and get started with migrating servers. So I'm going to click on Assess and Migrate Servers. As a first step in migrating servers to Azure, I need to select the tools that I'm going to use to perform the different phases of the server migration process. So I go ahead and select Add Tools. Since this is the first time I'm using Azure Migrate, I get the option of creating a new Azure Migrate project. An Azure Migrate project is a metadata repository which allows you to place your discovery, assessment, migration, and tracking related metadata in a centralized place. You have the option of placing it in a geography, a subscription, and a resource group of your choice. I'm going to go ahead and create a new resource group in my demo subscription. I'm going to call it Contoso Project. And I'll also go ahead and give my migration project a name. I'm going to call it Contoso Project. For geography, I'm going to select Europe. Note that you can migrate to any Azure data center of your choice using a project located in any geography. I click on Next. I now get presented with options of Microsoft and ISV tools that I can use to perform the discovery and assessment phase of the migration process. I can choose to use the Azure Migrate inbuilt server assessment capability, which lets you migrate VMware and Hyper-V virtual machines at scale to Azure, or use a feature or a capability from one of our ISV partners who've already integrated with Azure Migrate. Some of the partners in the listing are Cloudamize, Current Tech, Turbonomic, Unify Cloud, and Device 42. In the coming months, this list of ISV partners will expand further. For this process, let's go ahead and select Server Assessment. And then just like I did for the discovery and assessment phase, I also get an option of selecting between the Microsoft or ISV tools for the actual phase of performing migrations to Azure. I can choose the inbuilt Azure Migrate server migration capability, which lets you migrate VMware, Hyper-V, physical servers, or migrate VMs from other clouds to Azure. Note that for VMware, we now also support agentless migrations to Azure, or I can choose one of the integrated partners such as Carbonite or Current Tech. For now, I'm going to select server migration and click on Next. On this screen, I get to review my options. Now that I'm satisfied with my selection, I click on Add Tools, and I'll be able to start migrating my servers to Azure. You'll see that a new Azure Migrate project named Contoso Project is going to get created in my demo subscription. I'll be able to go to the project and start making progress with my selected tools. All right, it took maybe a few minutes and my project is created. And just as I had selected the Azure Migrate server assessment and Azure Migrate server migration tools have been added to my migration journey, where I'm going to use these tools to migrate servers from VMware and Hyper-V environments to Azure. Now, in one of my upcoming videos, I'll show you the process of performing assessments and migrations with Azure Migrate Server Assessment and Azure Migrate Server Migration. you'll be able to see how all of the information is going to get presented and tracked in one central place, which is the Azure Migrate experience. You'll also see the benefit of the end-to-end experiences that we've created for the migration process. This would have worked exactly the same if I had selected an ISV tool for the assessment and the migration phase. For example, if I had selected CloudMice to perform my assessments and Carbonite to perform my migration, on this screen, you would see tools representing CloudMice and Carbonite. Just as we did for server migration, we could have followed this exact same process for database migration. You'll see that you have inbuilt capabilities for database assessment and database migration in Azure Migrate. All right, everyone, that's it from me in this video. But before we wrap up, let's recap. We saw how to create the new Azure Migrate project. Azure Migrate is now a hub for all your migration needs and tools. We saw the guided experience for servers, which would have worked the same if you wanted to migrate databases. We also saw the feature-based grouping of Microsoft and ISV tools and how you can select the tool that works best for you for your migration scenario. And in the upcoming videos, I'll show you the benefits of the integrated experiences with end-to-end tracking. Thank you and keep watching.